नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
सर्वज्ञः means the all knowing one. The supreme lord is called as the all knowing lord, sarvajñaha. Now why is the lord called as all knowing? Because the lord is the illuminer of all the equipment through which we know anything. We know something through our senses when we see, hear, taste, smell, touch. We know something through our mind when we feel some emotions, or through our intellect when we think, or when we imagine, or we see some effect and we infer a cause. In all these, we use the body, mind, intellect to gain the knowledge. The Lord is the one who is the consciousness identified with this body, mind, intellect. And hence, as the illuminer, the Lord enlivens the body, mind, intellect and makes them capable of knowing. Without the presence of this consciousness, nothing would be known. Everything would be inert. The body, mind, intellect would be inert without the consciousness. So as the consciousness, the Lord pervades the whole universe. Not only the objects are able to function because of the consciousness, the subject in us, the I, the knower, also is able to function because of consciousness. And the Lord is the illuminer of both the subject and the object. To know something else, we need an equipment. But to know I am, we don't need any equipment, because that is the swaroop of ours. Jnana is our swaroop. And that swaroop of ours is infinite. As consciousness, we are infinite. Today, forgetting that we are the consciousness, we identified with one equipment and we think I am Mr. So-and-so, the knower who is experiencing the world of object, emotions and thoughts. But we are that pure consciousness. And that is the nature of the Supreme Lord, Sarvajnaha. So he is the knower in all the hearts. Hence, every single thought that arises also is illumined by the Lord. Hence, he is also called Sarvavit. Generally, he is the knower of everything because he is the illuminer. Objects are there. The bulb illumines the objects. Objects are removed. The bulb illumines the absence of the objects. In the same way, consciousness illumines the presence of thoughts, absence of thoughts. Thoughts depend on consciousness. Consciousness doesn't depend on the thoughts. Hence, consciousness is of the nature of knowledge, sarvajna. Even when the body, mind, intellect are absent or dormant in the deep sleep, your consciousness exists. And that's how we come to know that I had a power nap, I had a dreamless sleep, I slept like a log. That pure consciousness which illumines the knower in us, the act of knowing and the known, is the Supreme Lord. In the Nirvana Shatkam, Shankaracharya ji says, Aham bhojanam naiva bhojyam na bhokta chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham. So this name of the Lord as Sarvajnaha is mentioned in the Mundaka Upanishad also, many other Upanishads also. In the Mundaka Upanishad, it comes as Yaha Sarvajnaha Sarvavit, one who knows and illumines everything generally, and one who knows specifically also, Sarvavit, being in the hearts of all the beings. What is the practical implication of this, apart from the Vedantic implication that we are that one consciousness, that we should break out of this notion that we are a limited, finite knower? We are of the nature of knowledge itself. Infinite consciousness is our true self. That is the Vedantic implication. What is the practical implication? If Bhagwan knows everything, then when we understand this clearly, every single thought that arises in us, the Supreme Lord is aware of that thought. There is nothing hidden from the Lord. So there is nothing that we can do which is not known to the Lord. And we also know that Bhagwan is the karma phala data. So any action that we do, including desiring and thinking, they are subtle actions. Every single desire, thought, it arises by the grace of the Lord, and the Lord is aware of that. So a devotee who knows that Bhagwan is Sarvajna, has nothing to hide from the Lord, would spontaneously start walking the path of righteousness Because many times the thought in our mind is, when we do any adharmic thing or unrighteous thing, we feel we will get away with it. Nobody knows. But the Lord in the heart knows everything before even we act upon it. So practical implication of Sarvajna is to know that every moment the Lord is in our own heart, knows every single thought that arises. And the Lord has given us the free will. That what do we do with this knowledge? Do we walk on the path of Dharma or do we get distracted and fall for some temptations and pleasures? That free will Bhagavan has given to us. So we have to make the best use of that free will, walk the path of Dharma, because only through that our mind becomes purified, intellect becomes single-pointed, and we can come to realize our oneness with the Supreme Lord. So the knowledge of the Lord's nature as Sarvajna gives us the strength to walk the path of Dharma, makes us aware that we are never alone. Bhagwan is with us every moment. And whether anybody else knows it or not, the Lord knows everything. And the Lord has also given us that beautiful choice of how do we live our life. This is the first practical implication. One guru gave a banana to all the disciples and said, go and eat where nobody can see you. Many disciples went. Somebody went quietly into a forest and ate. Somebody went in near the river banks and ate. Somebody went into their hut, closed it, and they ate. But one disciple came back saying, I can't eat this. The guru said, why? The disciple said, because I'm never alone. The Lord is watching me all the time. So he's in my heart. He's aware of everything. Whatever actions I'm doing are by his grace. So I can't eat it because I'm never alone. The guru patted the boy and gave him a big hug saying, you got it. Second practical implication of this is when Bhagwan knows everything, we do our best and leave the rest. He knows everything. Whatever he does is the best for us. We do our Purushartha. What is in our hands, we must continue to do. And after that, we leave it to the Lord. We don't insist that this result I must get by this time in this way. Whatever result comes, I accept it Prasada Buddhi because he is aware of everything. Sadevo yadeva kurute tadeva mangalaya. Whatever that Lord does for us is for our good. With this faith, we learn to become more equanimous, more stronger, more balanced in facing various results of our life. Thirdly, we don't have to settle any karmic accounts with anybody. We keep doing our duties. Bhagavan takes care of all our karmic accounts. We should not come under any obligation or feel pressurized that I have to do something for somebody. As a part of our duty, what we have to do, we have to do. But if sometimes some things are not possible for various reasons, then we don't have to feel guilty. The Lord knows the best, and either the karmic account has been settled or the Lord will bring up some opportunity in future to settle the karmic accounts. So there was one devotee who was very sick. And when Puja Gurudev came to meet the devotee said, Gurudev, look at my condition, how bedridden I am, and my life is so wasted. And I am more sad because all these people have to take care of me. I don't want to be dependent on them. But I am helpless. What can I do? The Lord has put me in such a terrible condition. And Gurudev said, that Lord knows everything. You don't worry. Maybe they have some prarabdha. They have to settle their karmic accounts. You just surrender and live in remembrance of the Lord. Bhagavan takes care of everything else. So one becomes completely unburdened, completely stress-free, because the Lord knows everything. And he is the one who is in our heart as the conscience. And he tells us what should be done, what should not be done. So we must get in tune with that Supreme Lord who is the all-knower. That is the fourth implication. That when Bhagwan is the all-knower, the source of knowledge is the Lord. We just have to tune up with that Lord. And hence, in our culture, we believe that knowledge doesn't come from outside. Knowledge is all in our heart. Only ways and means to reveal that knowledge have to be found out. So many great masters, great achievers in our culture have discovered many things in science, art, literature, music, dance, etc. in the past, because they were in tune with the divine. Intuitive knowledge is the best knowledge. So instead of filling our intellect with more and more facts and information, what are we to do? We should learn to tune our mind to the Supreme. Information may be needed, necessary, there is no doubt, but not at the cost of intuition. When we tune the mind to the Lord within, all knowledge reveals on its own. So many great Vedic mantras are revealed to the rishis because of that. Even so many scientists, mathematicians, doctors, many of them in our culture have come to discover such precious knowledge because they learned how to tune up with the Supreme. Hence here, Lord Shiva's name is Sarvajnaha, one who is the knower of everything and everyone, one who is the all-knower. May we surrender to that Supreme Lord and discover our oneness with the Lord as Sarvajnaha.
Om Namah Shivaya.